To the complaint, there are no people in these photographs. I respond, there are always two people, the photographer and the viewer. Ansel Adams once said, photography is an art and a practice of creating durable images by recording light. The meaning of the word photography comes from photo, that is photons. Hence, photography means recording or capturing photons or other electromagnetic radiation, either chemically, by means of a light-sensitive material such as photographic film, or electronically by means of an image sensor. The medium may vary depending on the practitioner. There are basically two types of photography which are mostly used, colored photography and black and white photography. Color photography is a kind of photography that uses a media capable of representing the colors. This media can be produced chemically during the photographic processing phase. Whereas black and white, that is monochrome photography, records only a single channel of luminance, also known as brightness, and uses media capable only of showing shades of gray. Typically, to focus the reflecting light or emitted from objects into a real image on the light sensitive surface inside a camera, that is a film, a device is used which is known as lens, resulting in an electronic image sensor which processes electronically and stores the digital image file for subsequent display or processing. The result in a photographic emulsion is an invisible latent image which is later chemically developed into a visible image, either negative or positive depending on the purpose of the photographic material and the method of processing. A negative image on a film is traditionally used to photographically create a positive image on a paper base known as a print, either by using an enlarger or by contact printing. In color photography, light sensitive chemicals or electronic sensors inside the camera record the information of colors at the time of exposure. The basic phenomena behind this is to analyze the spectrum of colors into three channels of information, one dominated by red and another by green and the third by blue. In imitation of the way the normal human eye senses colors, the recorded information is then used to reproduce the original colors by mixing together various proportions of red, green and blue light. RGB color used by video displays, digital projectors and some historical photographic processes, or by using dyes or pigments to remove various proportion of red, green and blue which are present in white light. CMY colors used for prints. Black and white photography. In the early days of photography, photographers had no choice but to shoot in black and white or in monochrome, as it was the only available medium. But then, with the invention of Kodachrome in 1936, gave color photography to the world, black and white photography didn't die off with the invention of colored photography. Instead, it flourished. Many photographers regard black and white photography as the purest form of photography. So why black and white photography does still acclaims such commands? There are few reasons to it. One reason is that color is a distraction. It takes attention away from the visual building blocks of a great photo: texture, tonal contrast, shape, form and lighting. A photographer shooting in black and white has to learn how to use all these elements to create a memorable image. Another reason is that color photography, much of its mediocre, is so abundant that black and white makes a refreshing change. From an artistic viewpoint, color depicts reality, whereas black and white photography is an interpretation of reality. Black and white photography is considered a better art form of photography than colored photography. Because of certain reasons, like black and white film gives an aesthetic, craftsman-like quality that is hard to produce in color. It is not a substitute for color, but it is an abstract way of interpreting the world around us. Over the last two decades, shooting in color has become the norm of photography, and amateurs have almost abandoned black and white. This is a great pity, as many color photographs would look better in monochrome. Most people relate immediately to the color photograph, which is not unexpected, as we see the world in color. Without the distraction of color, other elements of photography stands out in black and white photos. Consequently, the photographers has to pay extra attention to lighting, textures, and basic photographic composition within his viewfinder's frame. The foundation of virtually all practical color processes, whether chemical or electronic, was first suggested in an 1855 paper on color vision by Scottish physicist James Clerk Maxwell, which was known as three color processes. It was based on the fact that the normal human eye sees color because its inner surface is covered with millions of intermingled cone cells of three types, one more sensitive than the other to the end of the spectrum we call red, one more sensitive to the middle or a green region, and one is which is most strongly stimulated by blue. The named colors have no objective existence in physical reality, but simply describe the sensations experienced when these all three types of cells are unequally stimulated by various wavelengths of the light. From James Clerk Maxwell's studies of color vision, he found that any hue could be made by mixing only three pure colors of light, red, green, and blue, in proportions that would stimulate the three types of cells to the same degrees that the real colors did. To emphasize that each type of cell by itself did not actually see color, but was simply more or less stimulated, he drew an analogy to black and white photography. If three colorless photographs of the same scene were taken through red, green, and blue filters, and transparencies made from them were projected through the same filters and superimposed on a screen, the result would be an image reproducing not only the red, green, and blue, but all of the colors in the original scene. The first color photograph made according to Maxwell's prescription, a set of three color separations of monochrome, was taken by Thomas Sutton in 1861 for use in illustrating a lecture on color by Maxwell, where it was shown in color by the triple projection method. The test subject was a bow made of ribbon with stripes of various colors, apparently including red and green. During the lecture, which was about physics and physiology, not photography, Maxwell commented on the inadequacy of the result and the need for a photographic material more sensitive to red and green light. A century later, historians were mystified by the reproduction of any red at all, because the photographic process used by Sutton was, for all practical purposes, totally insensitive to red light and only marginally sensitive to green. Framing with light and shadows, the word photography derives from the ancient Greek for painting with light. Photography is light, and the quality of the light determines the quality of the photo. Black and white gives the photographers freedom to take the photos in all sorts of lighting condition. The best light is still created by the sun when it's low in the sky. With black and white, you can also take photos during the middle of the day and on overcast days, which are indeed difficult lighting conditions for color photography. The secret is to make sure the light suits the subject. Midday light, for example, can be great for architecture but poor for portraiture. An overcast day is ideal for taking portraits but poor for landscapes. Black and white photos basically play in lighting and shadows without the distraction of colors. Hence, this is both a strength and weakness for black and white photos. In the right lighting conditions, black and white photographs are beautiful. However, in wrong lighting conditions, black and white images may look washed out or too dark. Because shadow and light play such a key role in effect of black and white photography, two pictures of the same subject can create very different look at different times of day. Color conundrums. Black and white photography is a good choice to make when the colors available in the scene just don't work together. In cases, photographers do opt for black and white to avoid colors that can distract the viewer's eye. Texture. Imagine the wall of an old building or rusty metal or weathered wood. Anything old normally has lots of texture, and textures look great in black and white. Texture is affected by the lighting conditions. Low reking light, typical of the golden hour of light near sunrise and sunset, makes texture stands out sharply. The soft light of an overcast day can also bring out texture, though it may need some help in post-processing by technique such as increasing contrast. The worst light for photographing texture is harsh midday light. The flatness of this type of light hides texture. If at any moment of time a photographer wishes to capture the texture of a specific object such as a tree trunk, rock face, or the wrinkles and lines in an older person's face, he will have to choose black and white photography because color can detract from texture photograph. Experiment capturing textures of the subject with black and white film. Result will have a big difference in both the cases. Style. All photographers have their own style for taking photographs. A photograph of a same object clicked by different photographers will have different compositions and different styles of portraying. The conditions that you use to take photograph and the type of photographs you take may determine which style you prefer. If you like to focus on the mood or the timelessness of a photograph, then black and white might be for you. But if you like to focus on action shots or the details in photographs, then color might be more appropriate for you. Most people enjoy a balance of the two styles. Mood. The choice of black and white or color can be a choice of mood. The mood in a black and white photograph is often serious and classic. On the other hand, the mood in a color photograph is energetic and contemporary. Focus. The focus of your photograph may help you choose between black and white and color. Black and white photographs produce excellent result while highlighting the subject. The mix of contrast and highlighting will provide a striking look to a photograph focused on a single subject. With fewer colors, a black and white photograph is easier to view and keeps the focus on the subject. This makes black and white photography very popular for portraits. If the subject is full of details or is very active, color makes a better choice. The range of colors and details in a color photograph will get lost in a black and white photograph. That's a kind of drawback in black and white photography. Purpose. The choice of style can also be based on the purpose of the image. With all the colors stripped from a black and white photograph, a timeless and elegant feel is created. This is often used in wedding photography and portraits. Color, on the other hand, picks out details and movements. This is especially useful for action or to ground a photograph in a certain time or place. Tonal contrast. We are used to seeing in colors. When colors are converted to black and white, they become shades of gray. Light colors become highlights and dark colors become dark tones. The difference between these shades is called tonal contrast. Black and white photographers utilize tonal contrast to make good photos. Shape and form. Shape and form are two very important visual elements. Every object has both shape and form. Shape is how the subject looks in two dimension. A silhouette like this photo of tree branches is an example of shape in a photo. Form is how the subject looks in three dimensions. Photos are two-dimensional, and like painters, photographers have the challenge of depicting three-dimensional objects in a two-dimensional form. Black and white draws attention to the shadows and flowing lines that depict the form. Use lighting to make your subject look three-dimensional. Side lighting reveals form by casting shadows. Front and back lighting obscure it. Timing. Black and white photography works better than color for bright, overcast days. Instead of showing a distracting, overexposed sky, the subject remains the focus. Black and white photography also works best when the lighting allows shadow to show shapes and details. In situations when it is dark or a flash is necessary, then color is more appropriate. In these lighting situations, black and white can look flat. Toni Frissell. In her legendary photo, Toni Frissell impresses with a strong trend towards surrealism or realism. The photo presented here, although in black and white, is both extremely sharp and clear. To achieve such level of clarity in black and white is extremely hard. Alan Ciorti presents example of modern street photography in black and white. Larry Towel. This shot was taken in El Salvador. Child with star mask during Day of Dead. Other child in background rolls tire for repair in garage where he works at an adult's job. The photo is full of tiredness and stubbornness, with the simple motive of conveying strong emotions. Shoot in RAW. Some photographers cannot shoot in RAW because their camera doesn't offer it, or they don't wish to shoot in RAW because they either don't know how to do it or either they don't like to do it. But for the most control in the post-production phase of converting your color images into black and white ones, you'll want to shoot in RAW if your camera does allow it. Of course, shooting in JPG doesn't stop you shooting in black and white, but if it's an option, give RAW a go. You might be surprised by what it offers you in post-production. Shoot in color. Suppose if the camera doesn't allow you to shoot in RAW, or you choose not to shoot that way, you can shoot in color and then you can convert it into black and white later on your computer while editing in post-production. While most digital cameras offer you the option to shoot in black and white and can reproduce some reasonable results, you have more control over your end result if you have the color data to work within your conversion on your computer. Low ISO. Shooting with the lowest possible ISO will produce a better result. While this is something that most of us do in color photography, it is particularly important when it comes to black and white photography. Noise created by ISO can become even more obvious and effective. If you are after this noise or grain, you can always add it later in your post-production. But it's harder to go the other way and take noise out. When to shoot? Many digital photographers actually prefer to shoot images for black and white in low contrast situations. So a dark or overcast day can be a great time to shoot outdoor shots. Ironically, these are the days that those who shoot only in color sit at home complaining about the poor light condition. So when next time you find yourself in a dark and gloomy day, shoot some black and white shots. Composition. Since both colored and black and white photography needs to compose or frame the subject, it is basically the most general tip. However, the main obvious difference is that we are unable to use the colors to lead the eye into or around your shot. This means we need to train ourselves to look at shapes, tones, and texture in our frame as point of interest. A particular attention is paid to shadows and highlights, which will become a feature of our shot. Learning to see in mono. The key to successful black and white photography is learning to see the world in monochrome. It's important to understand that not all subjects are suitable for black and white. There are certain types of photo that rely on color for impact. For example, a famous portrait of Afghan girls which was clicked by Steve McCurry. The rich colors are an intrinsic part of the image's power. The successful black and white photographer recognizes this and searches out subject matter that looks better in black and white. When you are evaluating your subject, try and imagine how it will look in black and white. Pre-visualize the result after you have post-processed or developed and printed if you use film. The image using your favorite techniques such as adding textures and toning. With practice, your vision will become very accurate. A good tip for digital SLR users is to shoot in the RAW format, which you should do for the best quality color to black and white conversions anyway. But set the picture style to a black and white mode. The photo will be displayed in black and white on the camera's LCD screen, and you will have all the colors information in the RAW file for your conversion afterwards. Subject for black and white photography. There are certain subjects that are ideal for black and white photography. Portraiture without color, attention is focused on the subject's eye and face and the texture of the subject's clothes. Sepia toned photos is very flattering and often used by commercial portrait studios. Elderly people with wrinkled and time-worn skin are wonderful subject for black and white. Both of these portraits were taken outside on cloudy days. This type of light is very flattering for portraits. Direct sunlight creates harsh, ugly shadows across the face and should be avoided. Landscapes. Black and white is a very effective medium for landscape photography. It draws attention to the shape and forms of the components within the landscape and the quality of light.